is it your Lord? You're so merciful. My hope is in you, Lord. You're beautiful. You're beautiful.
So beautiful you are.
The kindest man I know. You're beautiful. You're beautiful.
The kindest man I know.
The kindest man I know.
You're beautiful.
My hope is in you, Lord.
The kindest man I know.
We are your
Welcome to Greenhouse this morning. What an honor that we get to sit in this place of privilege and minister unto the Lord. And so this morning I was feeling this sense that God wanted to renew our hope this morning. As we dive into the scriptures, we're going to be going over Psalm 130. But this morning there's an invitation on the table just to, as we lift up Jesus, I felt renewed hope this morning in the room. I don't know what you've come in with, but I know that Jesus is the one that wants to meet us this morning. And so whatever it looks like, I just want to pray for us this morning as we minister unto the Lord, this renewed hope in His character, the renewed hope in His nature, knowing that He is a good, good Father. He's a good, good friend. It's like this undeserved place of privilege we have because of the cross. And so, Jesus, we just love you this morning, God. Oh, we lift you up. Jesus, you're the name above every name. Oh, Jesus, we worship you this morning. Oh, you deserve all the honor, all the glory. And this morning, I thank you. I thank you that you're going to reveal who you are afresh to us this morning. Every person in this room, Lord, I thank you that you dearly love. And that, God, you have something for them this morning as we lift you high. So, Jesus, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come afresh. Holy Spirit, come afresh. We love you, Jesus.
Want your embrace, Holy Spirit. We want your embrace, Holy Spirit. We want your embrace, beautiful Father, wonderful friend, Holy Spirit. We want your embrace, beautiful Father. Wonderful friend, Holy Spirit, we want your embrace, beautiful Father, wonderful friend, King Jesus, we want your embrace, beautiful Father. Wonderful friend, Holy Spirit, we want your embrace. Yes, we do, beautiful Father, wonderful friend,
Holy Spirit, and wonderful friend. Beautiful Father, beautiful Father.
beautiful Father and a wonderful friend.
Beautiful Father and a wonderful friend. You're beautiful Father and a wonderful friend. 'Cause it's just who you are, and it's just your nature. Oh, it's just who you are, and it's just your nature. Oh, it's just who you are, and it's just your nature. Oh, it's just who you are. Oh, it's just your nature.
It's just who you are. It's just your nature. It's just who
It's just who you are.
depths, I cry to you, O Lord. O Lord, you hear my voice. This morning we thank you, Jesus, that you hear this morning the prayers of your people. Out of our depths, God, out of our at times despair, God, you hear us. You're a good dad. You are the good shepherd. You are a God who hears. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my pleas for mercy. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness. This morning there is forgiveness at the foot of the cross. There is mercy. There is mercy. There is a merciful Father just waiting with his arms wide open this morning. It's your character and your nature, Jesus. The Lord, though we were once sinners, God, Lord, when we place our faith in you, there is this undeserved privilege, a place to stand, God, with you, God, where you say there's mercy, there's mercy, there's mercy. There's forgiveness, there's forgiveness, there's forgiveness. Oh, Jesus, we thank you. We thank you, God, that you sent Jesus to stand in our place, to die upon a cross, God, so that, number one, we could have an active relationship with you, Jesus. And number two, God, that we'd be forgiven, that there's mercy, Jesus. Oh, we thank you for your mercy this morning, God. We thank you. We thank you for the blood. We thank you for this place, God, that we get to stand. If you, O Lord, should mark iniquities, oh, how could we stand? Verse 4, but with you there is forgiveness, that you may be feared. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, we just remind ourselves of the cross this morning. It's so simple. It's so simple. It's so simple. The cross, we place our faith in the cross of you, Jesus, of what you did, God, that there's mercy, that there's forgiveness, and we come back and we say thank you for this place of privilege, God, that we get to stand now in right standing with you because of the cross. Oh, Jesus, we're so grateful. We're so grateful, Jesus. We're so grateful for the cross. We're so grateful, God, that you don't look at our sin anymore, that when we come into relationship with you and place our faith, there is full forgiveness. Oh, Jesus, we love you this morning, God.
There's forgiveness with the blood. I'm not condemned. There's forgiveness with the blood. There's forgiveness with the blood. I'm not condemned. There's mercy for me. I'm white as snow. I've been made clean. Oh, we thank you, Lord, for what you've done. For the blood, the battle's won. Oh, we thank you, Lord.
I thank you, Jesus, for the cross.
We thank you.
Thank you for your mercy. I thank you for your grace.
More than the watchmen for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is steadfast love. and with him is plentiful redemption. This morning, we just say that we wait upon you, Jesus. We're waiting upon you. Our soul waits for you, Jesus. We wait for you this morning, and we put our hope afresh in your word this morning, God. We know that your promises are true, Jesus. And so, Lord, we come as sons and daughters this morning to put our hope, Lord God, in who you are, in your character, in your nature, and in your word this morning. Oh, Jesus, we thank you, Lord. We come, Lord, just like the watchman of the morning, looking for you. Our lover, we're looking for you this morning, Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, you're meeting us in this place as we sit and we wait in your presence, God. Lord, we just thank you in that, Jesus, that you're going to renew hope this morning, God, that you're renewing, Lord God, what it looks like, Jesus, to even know your love at a deeper level. This morning, we thank you that there is steadfast love to be poured out this morning afresh. We thank you, Lord. So this morning, God, we put our hope afresh in you, God. No matter our circumstance, no matter what we're going through, we put our hope. We put our fresh hope in you this morning. Know that you are faithful. Oh, he is so faithful. Jesus, you are so faithful to your word. You are so faithful, Jesus. Oh, we magnify you, Jesus, this morning. God, you are the reason why we came. You are the reason why we're here this morning. We're not here for anything else. We don't want a good gathering. Jesus, we want your presence, Jesus, and we put our hope afresh in you this morning. You are hope. You are steadfast love this morning. So, Jesus, we wait upon you. Our soul longs for you, Jesus.
My joy is in you, Lord.
my joy, and now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. I've got joy, and now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. I've got joy, and now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? How could this be?
It's only by the blood.
Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be? It's only by the blood. Now I've got joy, now I've got peace. How could this be?
It's only by the blood.
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 By the blood I have joy, that I have peace.
It's only by the blood.
Oh, your love is so amazing, Lord. So amazing. Oh, your love is so amazing, so amazing, Lord.
Oh, it's so
amazing. Your love is so amazing, Lord.
Your love is so amazing.
So amazing, Lord. Your love is so amazing, and this joy I can't explain it. But I'm caught up in the fellowship. Now I'm caught up in the fellowship. Jesus, your love is so amazing, and this joy I can't explain it. But I'm caught up in your fellowship. Now I'm caught up in your fellowship. Jesus, your love is so amazing. Joy, I can't explain it, but I'm caught up in the fellowship. Now I'm caught up in the fellowship. Jesus, your love is so amazing, and this joy I can't explain it, but I'm caught up in the fellowship. Now I'm caught up in the fellowship. Jesus, your love is so amazing, this joy I can't explain it. So amazing, and this joy I can't explain it. But I'm caught up in your fellowship. Now I'm caught up in your fellowship. Jesus, your love is so amazing, and this joy I can't explain it. But I'm caught up in your fellowship. Oh, I'm caught up in your fellowship.
Jesus, here
you go again.
Joy, I can't explain it.
But I'm caught up in your fellowship.
I'm caught up in the fellowship. Your love is so amazing.
And this joy I can't explain.
I can't explain it.
But I'm caught up in the fellowship.
Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship. I've never known a love like this before. Oh, I've never known a love like this before. Oh, I can't explain it. Oh, I can't explain it. I'm never.
never known a love like this before. Oh, I've never known a love like this before. Oh, I've never known a love like this before. Oh, I can't explain it. I can't explain it. I've never known a love like this before. I've never known a love like this before. I've never known a love like this before. So amazing, it's a joy I can't explain it, but I'm caught up in the fellowship, oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship.
Jesus, your love is so extravagant, God. This morning we just thank you, Jesus, for your love. We thank you, Jesus, for your love, and I thank you for this room, God. I thank you, Lord, there's hope being renewed this morning on the character and the nature of Jesus. Oh God, we put our hope in you this morning. We thank you, Jesus. Isaiah 40, 31. I felt for us this morning, God wanted the renewed hope this morning of who he is. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. If you're weary, if you're tired, this morning, Jesus, we thank you. There is renewal of strength as we hope afresh in you this morning. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Can we just corporately together, let's stand this morning. We're going to enter a time of high praise. We're going to go into a moment of worshiping together corporately. So this morning, Jesus, we put our hope in you afresh. Wherever you are, can you just extend your hand just like you're receiving a gift this morning? I really feel like renewed strength is going to come this morning. Renewed hope is going to come this morning. Oh, Jesus, we love you, God. We magnify you. We thank you, Jesus, for what you're going to do this morning, what you've already started, as we put our hope afresh in you this morning. Oh, you're so faithful. Would you lift up your voice this morning? Tell him he's worthy. Tell him that you put your trust in him this morning. Tell him that we put our hope in you this morning, Jesus. Oh, we magnify you, Jesus. Oh, we love.
I'm caught up in the fellowship. Yeah, keep singing this. Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship, Jesus. Your love is so amazing. This joy I can't explain it, Lord. Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship, yes. Lord, I'm caught up in the fellowship, Jesus. Your love is so amazing, and this joy I can't explain it. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, oh. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, Jesus. Your love is so amazing, yes. And this joy I can't explain it, oh. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, Lord. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, Jesus. Your love is so amazing, yeah. And this joy I can't explain it. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, Lord. And I'm caught up in the fellowship, Jesus. Your love is so amazing, Lord. And this joy I can't explain it. Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship.
Oh, this love, Lord.
And I'm caught up in the fellowship. Love is so amazing, and the joy I can't explain it. Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship, Lord. Oh, I'm caught up in the fellowship of Jesus. Your love is so amazing, and the joy I can't explain it.
Oh,
I'm caught up in the fellowship.
I'm getting caught up in the
to be praised, Lord. Oh, you are worthy above all things, Jesus.
Return the breath you gave with our praise. mountains. Come on, keep singing that.
So we lift you high.
I just feel in this moment there's joy that's about to break out in this place. I just felt like we started to go in, but I feel like there's something about moving. There's something about releasing a praise, maybe when you don't even feel it. Last night at Monday night, Nick was talking about our emotions and our feelings. And this morning I felt the Lord was saying, would you come into agreement with my word? The joy of the Lord is your strength. This morning, would you come and would you praise from that place? Maybe you're not feeling like it, but not on my watch will I let the rocks cry out in my place. This morning, I felt like there was a shift for some of you. There was a shift where you've come in and you're like, I'm feeling down. I don't know why I feel depressed. But this morning, as we lift our praise to Jesus, as we focus on Jesus this morning, as we lift up our praise, as we lift up our worship, some of you, it's in complete faith because you don't feel like it. But as we go back in, can we just lift up our praise and our worship? Because I believe this is not just something random we do. This is a deliberate faith step of saying, God, I'm going to cry out. God, I'm going to lift my faith. I'm going to lift my praise to you. So can we go back in? Whatever you have to do, I don't care. Dance, yell, but let's lift up our praise to Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we magnify you. Oh, Jesus, there's something shifting in this room this morning. There is something shifting. Come on. Yeah.
We lift you up, Jesus. Lord, it is our pleasure to lift you up this morning, God. We get so low. We bow low before you, Jesus. Oh, just to lift your name up, God. Oh, we look at what you've done, Lord. We look at who you are, Jesus, and we cannot help but praise you. We cannot help but lift up a sound. Oh, unto you, Jesus, the one who's worthy. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. to stay in this atmosphere of rejoicing and praising the Lord. I just feel like God's going to move as we continue in this atmosphere and we continue in this attitude. But this morning we pivoted a little bit differently because I don't know about you, but I know that God has nations on his heart. And I know the reason we celebrate is because we have the good news of the cross. We have the good news that Jesus died, that he saved us, that he was resurrected, and we have this personal relationship. But the bleak news right now is that not everybody does know Jesus. And so this morning, we're going to turn this into a prayer meeting because we're going to be standing in the gap for my nation and the nation of New Zealand. So Australia and New Zealand, we're going to be praying for this morning. But I wanted it to be in this attitude of rejoicing and thanking the Lord as we stand in the gap, that as we pray, that things are going to shift in the atmosphere over the continent, in Jesus' name. And so what I'm going to do is, in a moment, I'm going to lead us through some prayer points, but I want to shout out this and honor some incredible people that you might not yet have met in the room. And these people, I've had the privilege of just being on a little tour together. Some leaders from Australia and New Zealand have come together to America to get some training, myself included, and they're here in the room right now with us as Circuit Riders. So can we give a big shout and say hello to all of my friends? The reason that I wanted to highlight them because at the end, we're actually going to pray for them because I believe that there is a new anointing, a new strategy for each and every one of them as they go back out into the continent and out into the nation of Australia and New Zealand. But what we're going to do first, is everyone ready? I feel like this morning it's just joy is just breaking out in this room, but we're going to pray right now. Our first prayer point, everyone say first prayer point. First prayer point is we're going to dive right now into the Bible and see what the Bible says about praying for the end time laborers. For the harvest is great, but the laborers are few. If we probably know it, Matthew 9, 30, that's this. Jesus went through all the towns and villages teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom. And he healed every disease and sickness. But when he saw the crowd, say when he saw the crowds. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, that's you and me, friends. We are the disciples now. We are going out like we do on tour, or if you're not a part of Circuit Riders, wherever you go, that we're called to go out and share the good news of Jesus as followers of Jesus. And he says this, the harvest is plentiful. Australia and New Zealand, the harvest is very plentiful. But the workers are few, so ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. So what I want is, could you link faith in faith for Australia and New Zealand and the Pacific, and there's islands all around that place, for a mighty move that the end time laborers would arise in that place. We are asking Jesus, there's a few of us in this room right now represented from those nations, but there are so many more that I believe that God in this hour and in this time wants to raise up because the harvest is plentiful. Can we say it again? The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. So right now, we're just going to go all in together. Right now, could we pray in the name of Jesus that God would raise up in Australia and New Zealand end time laborers? Let's lift our voice right now. Jesus, we thank you, Lord, that Australia and New Zealand, they would be end-time laborers, end-time harvesters, God. Oh, I pray, Lord, that you would highlight the ones who are meant to be and meant to reap a massive harvest in the nation of Australia. Yes, Jesus. Oh, we praise you and we thank you. We praise you and we thank you. Yes, keep praying. Keep praying. Thank you. university campuses and high schools of Australia and New Zealand. Guys, I want to tell you the harvest is really ripe. We've just done a tour and we've seen so many young people give their lives to Jesus. Suicides, interruptions. They are hungry in the Pacific for a move of God. And so what I'm gonna do is I have the privilege of inviting my friend Junior up and also Jess. Junior is a pastor in New Zealand. And then also Jess is a university pastor in Australia. And so what we're going to do is they're just going to pray out. But could we stand in agreement? Because these guys are the mighty ones standing on the ground, in the ground, in faith, believing. They're in the day in and day out. The verse I had for this prayer point is we're going to pray for a mighty wave of salvation. That the campuses where the enemy said no, their mind, today we are saying there's a tipping point in Australia. There's a tipping point in New Zealand. And we're going to actually go in and see the harvest. These campuses harvested for Jesus. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with Junior in New Zealand. And the verse I had is 1 Timothy 4:2. And it talks about Jesus desiring that everyone be saved. It says that God desires that all men be saved and comes to the knowledge of truth. So we're going to pray for these campuses to come to the knowledge of truth, that where the enemies tried to come in, we're standing in the gap in faith and also, I believe, rejoicing, being like, no, those campuses are ours in Jesus' name. So Junior, can you stand in the gap for New Zealand? Let's lean in.
Amen. Come on, right across this room. Why don't you lift your hands to heaven? Let's stand in the gap for New Zealand right now. Father, we thank you that you are able to do immeasurably more than whatever we ask, think, or imagine. So God, right now, we cry out for the nation of New Zealand across every university, over every high school. God, we pray for souls to be saved. Lord, we pray for the divine empowerment of the Holy Spirit upon every believer. Lord, we declare a fresh boldness over your church. And that, God, we would see heaven populated for your glory. We come against the schemes of the enemy. No weapon formed against your church will prosper. And Lord, we pray for a wave of salvation. May your kingdom come, your will be done in New Zealand as it is in heaven. In Jesus' mighty name.
Yes, Jesus. And Lord, we thank you for the nation of Australia. We thank you, Lord, that it's on your heart that none would perish, but that all would come to repentance. Jesus, we partner in faith with your will and your purpose for your kingdom to come and your will to be done on earth, in Australia, in our universities, in our capital cities, as it is in heaven. We thank you, Jesus, that you are raising up revivalists in universities. We thank you that you are
for this next point, because I believe this is how the tipping point's going to happen, is when believers across Australia, New Zealand, the nations, stand in agreement and unity. The Bible says where there is unity, God does command the blessing. So what I would love in this next prayer point, and as we're starting to wrap up soon, I just would love, could you just get into threes, max fours, and could you just stand in agreement together and pray wildly that in the Pacific specifically right now, because that's where we're praying, across ministries and churches, that we would see unity. We would seek God commanding that blessing upon everything. We're standing for an agreement because we want to see the nation saved. So just grab a buddy around and can you pray wildly that we would see unity and agreement across the nation of Australia and New Zealand. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you for unity and agreement across the nation of the Pacific. We thank you, Jesus, that every place, God, every church, every denomination, every leader, God, there'd be a tipping point, Jesus, where, Lord God, collaboration and unity in Jesus' name. We just thank you.
But we're going to pray wildly for these guys.
We're going to stand in agreement. If you have a word for them, give it to them. But let's cover them in prayer. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
every leader, on every leader in this room. We just thank you, Holy Spirit, that you so care so deeply about the pastors. Lord God, as the ministry leaders, God, you care. So we just thank you for your refreshing right now in Jesus' name. Fresh oil in Jesus' name. I thank you for wisdom. Wisdom in Jesus' name. I thank you for blueprints from heaven being dropped from heaven, Lord God, as they lead and as they minister, God. And so, Lord, we just thank you for every pastor and leader represented here from New Zealand and Australia. And we praise you, God, that even in 1 year's time, I prophesy there's going to be wild testimony coming back from their mouths of university saved, of high school saved, of churches being flooded in Jesus' name. So we just thank you right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We can clap. That's awesome. So good. Just in one last response, can we just lift our hands for a moment. I just feel like the Lord just wants to fill us all afresh for today and the assignments that he has in front of us. Man, if you haven't heard it today, you are so radically loved. You're so radically seen. It's not about ministry. It's about this authentic relationship with Jesus. Authentic. I'm still waking up. Authentic relationship with Jesus. And so, Lord, we just thank you for this relationship, God, out of intimacy with you, God. Today is intimacy with you. So, Lord, fill us, Lord God, as we, Lord, respond to you right now in Jesus' name.
True repentance, true repentance. King, let's sing it again. Oh, New Zealand will shout, Australia will see. How great is our God now? Oh, how great is our King, yeah, yeah. New Zealand will shout, Australia will see. How great is our God? Oh, how great is our King. New Zealand will shout now.
Amen.